In this example, we are given that water flows through a capillary tube of radius R and length L at a rate of 40 milliliters per second when pressure difference across the tube is due to height H of water column. Now it is saying another tube of same length and radius R by 2 is connected in series with this tube with same pressure difference across the combination. We are required to find a new flow rate. Now, in the situation, say, in the beginning, we are given with a capillary tube having length L and radius R. And say, the pressure difference at the two ends are P A and P B. If this end is A, this end is B. And we are given that P A minus P B is H rho G, where rho is the density of water, as it is given that the pressure difference is due to a height H of the water column. So, in this situation, we can find out the initial flow rate, which can be given as Q, and it will be equals to pi R2 power 4 by A theta L, and pressure difference is H rho G. This is given as 40 ml per second. Now, in second part of the problem, it is given that there is another tube of radius R by 2 is connected in series with this. A narrow tube is connected with this, which is having a radius half, but length is equal. And in this situation, the pressure difference remains same if it is PA and PB. We can consider, say, if delta P1 is the pressure difference across the first tube and delta P2 is the pressure difference across second tube. Here it is given that delta P1 plus delta P2 will be equals to H rho G in the final situation. And here if we find out the final flow rate in the second situation, say it is Q dash, then for the first capillary, it can be given as pi R2 power 4 by 8 eta L. And the pressure difference will take as delta P1. And the same is the flow rate through the second tube, as both the capillary tubes are connected in series. So, discharge rate must be same according to the equation of continuity. So, in this situation, for the second tube, if we write the Fajoli's equation, it will be pi R by 2 to power 4 by 8 eta L, as the length remains same, multiplied by delta P2 is the pressure difference here. So, on simplifying, we can see all the parameters will cancel out, and here we are getting 16 delta P1 is equals to delta P2. If we substitute the relation here, delta P2, if we substitute as 16 delta P1, it will give us 17 delta P1 as H rho G. So, we are getting delta P1 as H rho G by 17. If we substitute this delta P1 over here, we will be getting the new flow rate Q dash, which can be written as pi R2 power 4 by 8 eta L multiplied by H rho G by 17. So, pi R2 for 4 by 8 eta L into H rho G, this we are given with 40 ml per second. So, this is numerically we are getting 40 by 17 ml per second. That will be the answer to this problem.